Hey YouTube, it's me, Ari, and I'm back with another video. Yes, it is another room tour video, but it's probably not going to be as long as, like, my first one. Maybe my second one, I'm not sure yet, though. Just because there's a lot of stuff that's different, a lot of new figures have finally come in, and there's stuff to really show, you know? I apologize ahead of time if you hear my neighbors, or if you hear cars. I've explained them in previous videos, but it's just a situation that I don't really have that much control over. So I'm not gonna talk too much in here because, you know, all of this is the same as before. The only difference is I think these are finally up. The Hanukkah-kun, I think they're 6x6 collection, and they're finally framed. But because that's over here, sorry for the motion, that means this is over here. And then that also means that this section is a little bit different. I did get frames for some of my prints. I'm working on getting frames for more, but if people who have all of their prints know that are framed, it's a little bit of an expensive endeavor and it can take some time. The only other thing that's different, well, you see a little bit there that's different, is this shelf is now in here and it holds just kind of stuff that we still want, but we don't really know what we're doing with at the moment. And yes, that is Christmas wrapping paper. That black tote thing there, the drawer set, that's where my Nendroid parts go. And that is currently ordered in numerical order, of which the Nendroids that I have been released. Yes, it does mean that if something I get is a little bit older, I do have to move all the drawers around, but it's something that I am willing to do. I'm not too pressed on doing that. So we'll walk out here. And the first thing you'll notice is there's a bookshelf here, and there's figures up there. But first we'll go through this. This is where I keep some of my doodles and prints. That is a Golden Kamuy manga strip. And then down there, fairy tale, stuff like that. Here's a shot of the room. And then this side, there's another bookcase with more figures on top. And then here is just some more stuff. Little prints, movie promotionals, stuff like that. So I guess I'll start over here. This is my desk. My desk used to be back to back with my boyfriend's on the other side of the room. Sorry, that my figure collection is indeed open. And here's the wall. Most of my Fire Emblem stuff's over here. I have another set of 6x6 Demon Slayer prints by the same person who did the Hanukkah-kun ones in the other room. That is one of my newest art additions. It is an Oren High School Host Club print. I just finished reading my manga box set and I was feeling super sentimental and I bought a bunch of Oren stuff and pre-ordered some Oren stuff that had come out. On my desk, there's a Fire Emblem Three Houses calendar, some card boxes, a little Gudetama, just an AmiAmi card. My pen cup is an old Tokyo Ghoul mug and it has a bunch of keychains on it. There's Naofumi, Zenitsu and both of the brothers from the Fates series for Fire Emblem. My laptop is covered in anime stickers, but that's how I like it. And then over here, a Kiznaiver mousepad, all of my 3D keychains, and my ghost type Pokemon plushies. Next is my bookcase. On the top here, we have Hina and Hodaka from Weathering With You, my favorite anime movie that is not Ghibli. I don't really like anime movies, as people know, but this one, Weathering With You, and now Your Name, are two of my favorites. They are very good, and I apologize in the past to people who know me, or have said otherwise. I have a Shoshomaru Inuyasha Giant Pop. I don't really like pops, but I like them in the box. I think it can make a really nice display piece. My Good Smell Arena. She moves around often, but she happens to be up here right now. My Joker and Morgana. Persona 5 Dancing Stars scale figure. My newest addition, which is this 1/7 scale, Hifumi from New Game in her witch outfit, which is actually from a game called Kirara Fantasia. I just learned that. It's, it's happening. And the fact that there's more Hifumi merch out there that looks like this and I didn't get it really hurts my heart. They're currently making Kokowa, I'm pretty sure, from Is the Order a Rabbit in her style like that. And then back here, I have a Hikari, or Pikari, from Amachu, and a Rotom. And then all six Osamatsu-san brothers. Next is this amazing Azura thank you card I got from my lady who does my Fire Emblem stickers on Etsy. She's fantastic. The first shelf is a lot of BL. I'm okay with BL. I'm not, like, weird about it, I guess. I think there's some good stories in the BL genre. And then my Kami-sama Kiss, Ancient Magus Bride. And then we have Futaba and Hikari, which I got last Christmas, and I love them so much. And then these, I call them my food nendroids, because all of them have, like, almost every accessory surrounded by, like, food and restaurants. But most of them, besides Choyo, I can't remember how to pronounce her name, I'm sorry, don't have a partner, and probably never will have a partner Nendroid, so. But I do have the rest of Is the Order a Rabbit Nendroids coming, so she might have to move. Okay, my next shelf is where my Kaon Nendroids like to live, and two acrylic stands in Zenitsu, which are actually supposed to be more like this, but okay. And then these are some of my completed manga series, Sweetness and Lightning, Princess Jellyfish. And then I have Drifting Dragons, which is a great read. Wodokoi, which I have the next volume coming soon. And Kaon, the first and last volume. And the first volume of The Way of the House Husband. Next shelf down, we have Golden Kamuy 1 through 17. Yomushi Petal 1 through 7. And Plunder Volumes 1 and 2, and then in the back there is Hanako Volumes 1 and 2. I have a paper scene, I guess they call them, from Ni no Kuni 2. And then just some plushies, a Zenichi badge, and another card box. But people are here for the Nendroids! I know, I am. Here's a cup full of bookmarks, because I lose my bookmarks all the time, so I always need to have a spot to put them back when I'm done using them. My three main people from No Game No Life, we have Sora, Shiro, and Jibril. My Crom amiibo, because I love Crom and I'm broken that they didn't make any Crom figures other than his amiibos. And then my Corrin and her two sisters from Fates, Elise and Sakura. Next shelf down, we're starting to get a little bit more awkward with it. My Love Story limited edition pins that I haven't opened yet and I probably never will, Deku and Kachan plushie keychains, and Toto and Makishima purse keychains of their heads. And then I have all six Osamatsu Figmas down here for now. And then just more manga, you know, After the Rain, which is a great series, Inuyasha, Demon Prince, that kind of stuff. And then down there is just a pile of plushies and miscellaneous manga.
It's pretty great.
And then we'll go through this one a little bit. Even though it's not mine, but you know. So at the top here we have Lucky Star X, it's a Contai collection, I think. I'm not very good at these. And then a UA and a Moogie from two different figure prize lines, but that's okay. Next, we have some rubber straps we can go through. We have Shishomaru, Inuyasha, Ranga from The Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime, Vegeta, Bakugo, and a hanging strap, Choromatsu. And then on the other side is all the Demon Slayer ones, and I have more coming. So this is the first edition box. This is not. This is from a different thing, but I still love her. This was the whole reason why I got this set. I think I say that every single time I show that thing off. And then that is all of them. So I'll go through the first shelf. We have Shinraku Sakabe, Senku, and Goblin Slayer. This is going to be the Nendoroid shelf for shonen characters that don't have anyone else in their series. And then back here we have My Hero Volume 1 through 25. 25 just came in yesterday. The Pocket Watch from Fullmetal Alchemist. Vigilantes Volume 1 through 3. Spy Family 1 and 2. And then just some, we don't look at those. Those are Faku books. This is My Boyfriend, My Significant Others, whatever you want to call them. Yu-Gi-Oh! Shelf. They do be liking that Yu-Gi-Oh! Stuff. And then down here, we have a Suyu pop for my brother and his girlfriend, and a Elias pop I got, like, a while ago now. Battle Vixens 1 through 15, I believe that's all that there is for the English print. Dead Man Wonderland Volume 1 through 13, Rahiro 1 and 2, and then some light novels. And then we have the Kill la Kill Android line, and then Ed and Al from Fullmetal Alchemist. Damn. Alright, let's keep going. Down here is mostly just like miscellaneous Shonen Jump manga, and one light novel volume of Goblin Slayer. And then down here is art books, but I can definitely show you guys a couple of my favorites. Oh, my bones popping. I do really love the Zelda collection, of course. That's a couple other cool ones. This is my Fire Emblem Three Houses special edition one. This is the Yu-Gi-Oh! Art book that my boyfriend loves. This is my Inuyasha art book for the manga. This is my Sarazanmai art book. It's more about, like, animation art book than, like, original art. This is my Hanako-kun art book. My Yomushi Petal art book. As you can see sort of online. This is my Yuru Camp art book, and I love it with all of my heart and soul. And then a couple of Studio Ghibli ones. Okay, so now we'll do probably the walls over here by my significant other's desk. We have an Alliance banner from World of Warcraft. We don't really play World of Warcraft anymore. They're definitely on that Genshin impact, but it's still something that they care for and they like. I got them a Xenoblade Chronicles 2 painting, again from Ari, and a Xenoblade Chronicles 2 print with Mithra and Pyra. And then he just has some amiibos, an Astolfo prize figure, and a Yugi and Kirito in the Gun Gale style, non-scale but not prize figures. And then over here, we have more Shovel Knight, a Goku with a tiny Asuna on his shoulder, Yu-Gi-Oh! Prince, Lisbeth, his waifu in the Gun Gale style, which, just to preface, because there has been a lot of Gun Gale, he does not like Gun Gale, it just happens to be the things that he gets because he likes the design. Theo from Grand Crest War, Shion from Brave Frontier, and then Asuna and Kirito Nendoroids. This is a great little Yoshi's Island, I'm pretty sure, print. Yoshi's Island print, and these are his Asuna and Alice stuff. And then a signed thing from Mike Pollock. And his switch case and bag. Here are the hats. You're definitely a hat person. And inside this closet is all of the Yu-Gi-Oh! And other card game stuff, because he is definitely a king of games. And here are all the Yu-Gi-Oh! Boxes. We'll go to his shelf next. We just got this because I felt bad that his amiibos were kind of everywhere, and they're definitely the kind of person that want to have them all compiled in one space. So this is going to be the amiibo shelf, but at the moment we need more of the acrylic risers, which are hopefully going to come back in stock soon. This is a 1/8 jury scale figure that we have. A bunch of amiibos, a bunch of Zelda and other Smash Brothers amiibos. Down here, we have a Senku prize figure and the 1/7 scale Pyra Good Smile scale figure, which this isn't the greatest place, but hopefully one day we'll have a better one. A Risk Metal Gear Solid game that's never been opened, and this is a double mat tube that he had to get, or there's a double mat inside for Yu-Gi-Oh! That's just the tube it came in, but they don't make them big enough. And then the Pokemon Sword and Shield pre-order bonus, the Galar pennant, a One Punch Man poster in a frame, Link's Awakening. I don't think it was a pre-order bonus, but I think you got it if you came in the day of to get it. My Tokyo Mew Mew sticker collection, which I framed because I never want to use them because I like them. I don't really like using stickers. I like framing them. My Pokemon X My Hero Boys and Girls print. A Legend of Zelda poster that's kind of old and beat up, and we might either try and get a new one or just get rid of it. The Boku no Hero Academia little sticker set I got from a friend from a con I couldn't go to. And a Robin and... oh my goodness, Lucina! Robin and Lucina print. Which I'm not really a Robin and Lucina shipper, but I thought the art was really nice of them holding hands. My little Umaru cape with an Ava thing to block out the sun that comes through that window and blinds me every day. A little manga wall strip. That was fun to make. It's definitely shoddy. It was my first attempt, and I don't own this house, so I didn't use Mod Podge or anything. It's all just like tape and like glue on like a bigger piece of paper. So next apartment, I definitely want to try again, hopefully better, but yeah, that one is not great. I have a little Rimuru pillow with a Grumpy Cat pillow on my couch. I sit here like all the time. I love this couch. It's great. And then last is the living room. A lot of new stuff here. A lot. So over here, I guess we'll start here. Konosuba pillow, Kirito blanket, and then we have all of my little Yuru Camp Nendoroids. I love them. One more coming, and that'll be a complete set. We have Sonic, and then just going down, some acrylic keychains and other Nendoroids that don't really have groups. Sakura from Zombieland Saga will have a group eventually, and Merlin, but the rest of these don't really have groups, so they just kind of hang out here in the singles club. And then just, excuse me, a couple wipes for this little table. Next is my Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime section. So yeah, there's a lot, and then there's even more. I have more figures pre-ordered for this, so this is definitely going to get disbanded eventually. I just love this anime, and I love Rimuru. He's such a great character for me, and I love the designs of stuff. Next shelf down is a My Hero shelf. This used to be a Miku shelf, but that had to get moved because, again, too many figures. Let's go to the side first. I have Eraser. There is Todoroki, Deku, and Bakugo. All Might at top, telling everyone good job. And then here's my other Deku. This tiny little Uravity. And then just some prize figures of the boys. Next shelf down is Lord Einzel Gon. Hold on. There we go. Here's Lord Einz. His light blew out, and we had only turned him on 3 times. So I'm very upset that I can never turn him on again. But there he is. In his all of his glory. There's a wedding Albedo coming out. And I think that's the one I'm gonna get to go with him. Cause all the other Albedos are like $500 plus for pre-owned. And then here's just half of a Zelda shelf. The other half is next to this. And I couldn't fit them all. So I decided to put like the Figmas and like some of the single Nendoroids here. Down there it's just like plugs and stuff. But then I put the other ones over here. Now, I've gotten comments before about sun damage and stuff like that about my Nendoroids, and I would just like to say, please don't worry your pretty little heads about my collection. I promise you I know what I'm doing with my collection, and I know, you know, how to take care of them, and I know what I'm doing. So here is the Wind Waker set, and then down here is the Breath of the Wild set. And then we have my Kingdom Hearts trio. Joker and Morgana. Elf, Yamada, and Sagari. And my Konosuba set, which Megumin will be joining them hopefully this week. I just got an email saying she shipped after like so many months. And then I have my Code Realize acrylic. And then up here, I just got these in, and I love them. It's Asuna and Yuki in school uniforms, EXQ figures. Sorry if the lighting's not great, it is kind of early here, but I think they look absolutely great. And then a Hanji prize figure and sepia-toned Tanjiro, which he's here. That is where he is. So down here, we're gonna pass everybody. I've found a new bookcase, and it's a small one for my living room. But I keep my Noragami volumes here, and a little tote, I guess you'd call it, where we keep like the Switch controllers and stuff like that. And then as you can see, all of my Demon Slayer stuff's finally here. I'm so excited. I have never gotten to show this stuff off really before. Tanjiro, Nezuko, Nendoroids, I have Inosuke and Zenitsu's pre-ordered as well, but with how things are at the moment, God can only hope that, you know, things will actually come reasonably timed. But yeah, they look great. I've been trying to get these prize figures for so long since they first came out, and I just kept having issues with companies I'd pre-ordered them through saying they didn't have enough stock, and I just was a sore loser and I didn't get any, and it really sucked, but they're finally here. And that makes me really happy. And then the next shelf down is my Orin High School Host Club box set. My Tokyo Mew Mew complete with a la mode, which I just got in yesterday. My Sacrificial Princess and the King of Beasts 1-4. I hope to get more of this soon. I just keep forgetting. And my My Love Story box set, which is also pretty great. We can do some of my shelves here. Down here is just kind of miscellaneous. Monster Hunter amiibos and a Android 17, I'm pretty sure. Sorry, one of my things in my next shelf fell and I have to fix it. Oh my goodness. There we go. This is my Yomushi Petal shelf for now. Mostly Makishima Yusuke, but I do have a couple other people, so I feel like I can't call it just the Makishima Yusuke shelf. I do love Makishima Yusuke. Still, to this day, he's still a great character to me, and this series is absolutely wonderful. And if you want a sports anime to watch, you should probably watch Omoshi Petal. It's always going to be my first recommendation for sports. And then next is my Pokemon shelf, with both lilies and, in red for now, a Rayquaza card holder. That is a Guardian Breath of the Wild amiibo, so don't worry about that. But yeah, we have some Pokemon amiibos, as you can see. And then down here, we have my Switch and a Switch charger. My Winter Isabel, which I also have the Spring Isabel Nendoroid ordered, but again, I don't know when that actually is going to end up coming to my hands. And then all of the Animal Crossing amiibos. And then just like game systems and stuff like that. So next we have my Three Houses prints. We have Claude, we have Dimitri, and Lady that I don't really like. And then we have a great Persona 5 print. I think it's so cute how they're all just kind of floating around. And then up here we have my Osamatsu minis and two Overwatch Nendoroids that are very finicky, and so we keep them over here because we don't have the energy to keep dealing with them falling apart. No, they are not fake. I know people instantly put together finicky Nendoroids with fake Nendoroids. They are real. They are just very, 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 very touchy. Over here is where the current Miku situation is. It's not going to be forever, but I think this is fine for now. I had to move him over here because I just got this little lady in. I've been wanting this Nendoroid for so freaking long. And I finally got her for a fair price. And then underneath are my anime DVDs. Most of them are still the same. A couple new ones are Demon Slayer and the Lucky Star Complete Collection. And then over there are some games. This is my coffee table. Change out the magazines every once in a while. And then the last little area to really talk about is my Nendoroid shelf right here. I have Hifumi and Alba from New Game, one of my favorites, Shida and Marth from Fire Emblem, the Sun Banzakura set, the Yuri on Ice main trio, Giorno and Bucarati, because JoJo Part 5 is my favorite part of the animated, and Umaru and Ebina as my final two little Nendoroids to show off. So, out of everything, I currently have 105 Nendoroids, I believe, in my house, and then I have like another 11 ordered. I definitely like Nendoroids, that's all I can really say. But yeah, here's a shot of, you know, all this open space that's been given. It's like crazy, dude. But yeah, I know this has been a super casual, like, house tour. I mean, I just, with school and how the world is at the moment, I really don't have a whole lot of energy, but I did want to show off how things have changed here just because I have had people asking me on, like, Discord and Instagram and other places, so I thought a video recording of it would be better than just 1,000 pictures. Again, I apologize for my neighbors and the car noises if you heard any, but I hope you enjoyed this very casual video. If you did, please share, like, and subscribe, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!